That was quite some press conference. I think fair to say, sincere animosity, not just hype.
I believe so, yeah. Definitely, obviously, started on social media and things like that. But now it's become very real where we do have the opportunity to actually fight each other and punch each other in the face. So I think it's going to be great.
I mean, we're used to seeing fighters calling each other out in press conferences, but there's some very specific and quite hard allegations during the course of that. I guess, first of all, talking about the junkie comments, I mean, can you talk a little bit about that? Because I think it seemed very clear that you felt that was a particularly hypocritical thing to be called in this context.
Mate, very much so. The first one was clenbuterol, and I was completely cleared of it. So pretty much take that off the table. The second one was a pre-workout, which is completely my fault. But it's pre-workout, which is the exact same thing he got done for. So how are you calling me a junkie when you got done for the exact same thing? That's basically, yes, 100% hypocritical. But again, he's going to have to and create all this to make to sell the fight. So this is what he's doing.
I think obviously being called a cheat and a drugs cheat is a terrible thing for an athlete. But also the allegation of racism is, I think, something which takes things in a completely different direction. Okay. Can you talk a little bit about, because I think, again, during the press conference, you seemed very upset, I think, at the lack of opportunity to clear yourself of that quite serious allegation.
It's a bit of both. It's him sort of making something very small into something very big. It was in reference to obviously having the long arms. I don't have long arms. I'm exactly 196 and 196. I've got friends that have got, you know, their hands go down past their knees. They've just got big long arms. My girlfriend's one of them. But in saying that, I think he's taken that to heart and thought, oh, here's something I can use and let's go for it, which is fine. But I'm in no way racist. Yeah, as I said, I've grown up being the only white kid in primary school, for example. All my friends are Lebanese or Islander, Pacific Islander background. I was married to a Filipino, so I've got three half Filipino kids. My current missus is Jamaican. Like, it's just it's furthest from the truth for me, and I do take offence to that. Yeah.
Can you talk about what this fight means for you, not just in terms of the personal rivalry, but as at this point in your career?
I'm 38 years old. I need to get on with it. I've been relatively inactive for the last 3 years, three fights in 3 years. So for me, it really does sort of propel me into the spot where I need to be. He's got great rankings. He's got the WBC belt. So yeah, it's perfect for me to get back to exactly where I need to be.
In terms of your approach to the fight from a technical point of view, I mean, do you see your power being, for you, obviously the deciding factor?
I think it always is. It's a matter of me being able to set myself up for the shots. I don't want to stand and just sheer trade, like one-for-one sort of thing. I think that's just silly for anyone in the heavyweight division. So for me to get my footwork right and be able to set those shots up would be perfect.
I mean, obviously, I think it's very clear what you think of your opponent as a man, but as a fighter, how do you actually rate him?
He's all right. I think personally he's like the gatekeeper. So he is very good. And as I said, he's much like Chisora, where Chisora was extremely good, but not quite world title holder level. So he fought for the world title and lost. I think White will be much the same, where he might fight for a world title, but I don't think he'll win one.
I'm curious, when there's this much emotion, I mean, it's very evident from the press conference today, is it hard not to carry that with you into a fight? I mean, in terms of maintaining your game plan, does that get difficult when you have such genuine hatred for the person you're in the ring with?
For me personally, no, I won't carry any of that into the fight. I'm very much, this is what I'm doing and this is how I'm doing it. For him, I think he needs it. I think he needs to have the emotionally charged sort of background to be able to sort of come into a fight. So I'm going to be sharing him as much as I can over social media from now till the fight and see how we go.
Obviously, this is a huge year for the heavyweight division, for fight fans in general. But can you talk a little bit about how you feel about some of the other big fights we've got coming up? And I guess particularly AJ, I mean, obviously, a fight that you, to some extent, were in and out of at times.
I think it's 70-30 split for AJ. I think he's just a little bit too good for Parker. I still think, again, it's a heavyweight division, so you never know what's going to happen. But I think AJ is a little bit too polished for Parker. And then you've got Wilder and Ortiz is another one that obviously everyone's going to be watching. So I think if Ortiz does turn up the way he should, being a crafty, big lefty, he's going to trouble Wilder for sure. But I think Wilder's going to knock him out in the end. I just want to say thank you. Honestly, it's really good to be able to come into another country and get received as well as I have, which is great. And just stay tuned. It's going to get interesting and it's going to get dirty and it's going to get violent.